Hey everyone, it's Nick Valenti with NJ Valenti Art, and in today's video, I'm going to show you how to create a vector snowflake in Affinity Designer. Okay, so to get started, I want to set up some guidelines for myself. I'm going to go ahead and turn the snowflake off for now. I'm going to come over here and select the pen tool. I have snapping on. I'm going to come down to the center of our canvas. Click, and by holding shift, create a straight line. Once I do so, I'm going to hit escape to terminate that line there. I will now hit V, select my move tool, and come up to window and select transform. Now, to duplicate this line, I will hit Control J on Windows or Command J on Mac. I've got the center node selected, so it will rotate around center. And I will come in here to the rotation and hit 30. I will now hit Control J, or again, Command J on Mac. Okay. I'll go ahead and close out the transform window for now. And then I will select all of these and group them. So I will call this guide. So we'll hop over to the pixel persona, and from here I'm going to select my paintbrush tool. I want to come up here to symmetry, and I want to change the symmetry to 6, as I currently have it here, and I want to select mirror and lock. Now you can see that these line up pretty much with the guide we just created in the designer persona. So what I'm going to go ahead and do now is I'm going to create a new pixel layer. I will switch my color to white. If I come in over the brushes and you go into inks, I'm using the Comics G Pen. I've got my white selected. And now we can draw whatever type of pattern we want for our snowflake. So we're going to zoom in just a little bit here. And this is where you can get fun and creative and try different shapes. Try a few different things. So you can come up with some pretty cool, interesting effects. You could even try something like this. And once you get something you're happy with, we can hop back over to the designer persona. Now, once we are in the design persona, I do want to take our guide that we created and bring it up to the top to give us a better look at what we've got going on here. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to create, using the pen tool, I'm going to outline this shape here in just one of these sections, all right? And then we'll turn it into a symbol and we'll be able to duplicate it around the snowflake. So for now, I'm just going to go ahead and trace off this one section, and we'll go ahead and speed this process up just a little bit. So now that I have that section made, I can come in here and turn this off real quick. I'm going to zoom in on this. Just kind of make sure that I'm kind of just about in the center of my guidelines here. It's looking okay and pretty good for right now. We'll be able to mess around and clean this up a little bit more here too in a little bit. But what we're going to go ahead and do is, with the object selected, I am going to come up to Window and select symbols. And you can see I have some in here from what I was working on earlier. But with this object selected, I'm going to go ahead and click create. So that has now created a symbol there. And if we come up here to the context toolbar, I do want to click on enable transform origin. And I'm going to take this and I'm going to slide it all the way down here to the center of our guide. With that symbol selected, I'm going to click Control J, Command J, that will duplicate. And with the origin selected there, I'm gonna go now and click on Rotate and hold Shift. So we'll shift it. Okay, and now I'm gonna go ahead and hit Control J. I'm gonna come back to our first shape here. I will Control J again, and this time I'll come up here to the top and I'm gonna flip horizontal. I will hold Shift with snapping on until it snaps to the other side here. Now, I will unclick from that shape and select that shape again. I've got the origin still set to the center here. I will Control J. And once again, hold Shift while rotating and Control J again to make my way around the rest of the snowflake. So taking a closer look at this, I'm gonna come in here and turn off my guide for now. You can select any one of the symbols here, and if we open it up, it selects the curve itself. As we come in here, whatever change we make to one aspect or one part of the symbol will affect the other parts as well. So we could go ahead and could take care of any little gaps that we may have, any places, a way for us to tidy things up. And also, it's a way for us to have one design and then be able to try multiple things with it. So I've turned my guide back on. You can also create a snowflake simply by creating it in Vector without having to draw it first in Pixel Persona. So we'll go ahead and do that here. I'll kind of duplicate and mimic the snowflake I have off here to the side, okay? So again, I'll grab my pen tool and I'm gonna focus just on creating my snowflake shape. I'm gonna make it too complicated. And then we'll come down here and back up to the top. So we'll go ahead and make that fill white. You want to come in here, I'll add two more nodes quick. Oh, three more nodes. I'll move this to about the center there. There we go. Okay. Hey, now with the move tool selected, I'm going to select this object. The symbols palette is still open, so I'll go ahead and click Create. Now I've turned that into a symbol. I've got my Enable Transform Origin on, so I will move that to the center here. Control J, Command J on Mac to duplicate. I will now hold Shift as I rotate that, and Control J again to fill that out. I'll come back to our first one here. I will duplicate that, Control J, flip horizontal. I will hold Shift until it snaps into place. I will click off of that object and then select it again, Control J, and now hold Shift to get it in line and Control J to power duplicate that back around. And just like that, we have another snowflake. This one we made just in Vector. We could come into any one of the symbols. So say we come into this one here. My node tool A selected, I can come in here and make any tweaks that I need to. Sometimes they get a little finicky and you got to play around with the shapes just a little bit, but having it in the symbols will allow you to do that. So there's a couple of ways of creating snowflakes in Affinity Designer. Using the pixel persona and the mirror symmetry option is a great way. You can really come up with a lot of really cool and unique designs for your snowflakes. I will have a link in the description below to my Patreon page where I will share sections of a snowflake that you can then use as a template to create your own. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please like, subscribe, and hit the bell so you don't miss out on any new videos. And if you'd like to support the channel directly, you can donate by clicking the Super Thanks button directly below the video. Thank you so much, and until next time.